3 years old, living with my 17-year-old mom, who was an addict. She was addicted to crack cocaine, so it was just myself and my sister, and I was the one who was taking care of my mom. We didn't have no other family around me.
Well, I think I felt like the parent, and I knew that as a child I shouldn't feel that way, and that kind of let me know that something was awry. I never had any food in the house. My mom wasn't really around. I was taking care of my little brother. He was 2. I was 7 turning 8. My mom, unfortunately at the time, was a drug addict, and as she was battling that, I was constantly on the lookout for my little brother in a house full of dangers that a child really shouldn't be exposed to. I knew I was going to die. I was suicidal, and when I was growing up, I was pretty much marginalized for my skin tone. I was darker than my family. In addition to that, you know, there was abuse, a lot of abuse, mental, physical. And when I was in grade 3 or grade 4, a person tried to molest me. And when I tried to tell my mother, she basically shut me down, and I lost my trust in my family.
Coming home after school was always troubling and worrying for me because of my mother's unstable mental health condition. I wasn't sure who I was, I wasn't sure where I was headed, and I was still learning a lot of things about myself and those around me.
I didn't want to get my mother in trouble, so it was, I think, a traumatic situation. I very much felt like I was betraying her. At times I still do feel like I betrayed her, because I felt like, especially where my culture and where I'm from, you don't do that. So even if there's issues at home, you bottle it up and you continue, you don't tell on your parents.
My perspective on family changed after being brought into care. Initially, it was really hard for me to love the idea of a mom. I was angry.
My foster mother really encouraged me building a relationship with my mother. And that's when me and my mom rekindled our relationship, and I was pretty inseparable from her until she got back on the drugs when I was about 19. So when I got news my mom committed suicide, I was pretty heartbroken. I had no idea that life was getting that tough for her. She never said goodbye to me or to my sisters.
After I was taken into the care of Children's Aid Society, I felt relieved. I felt right away that I could be given food and shelter, the basic needs that every child needs and deserve in life.
I didn't know what to think, because I didn't even know what Children's Aid Society was. I realized that this is my way of escape, to kind of, you know, get another environment for myself so that I'm more safe than going back home.
I do still love my maternal mother, but unfortunately, because of her state, I never received the emotional support and care that I did with my foster family.
I also began realizing that family isn't just what you're born into, and family isn't just, you know, blood relatives, it's also the family that you create.
We can be merciful. Go dancing at the ball.
Sometimes you'll never get over the hurt that you've been through. But at the end of the day, although I may cry some days, I know that I'll laugh, and I'll cry from laughing some days too. So I know that happiness is there, even though there's uncertainties ahead of me.
It was not until then, when I, you know, aged out and I met my worker, and she helped me in times when I didn't even believe in myself. She believed in me, and she said to me, no, you can do university, not just college.
One of my best experiences in life was first opening my acceptance letter into the University of Toronto, because from that point forward, I saw my life as going somewhere. It definitely will be a memory that I will remember for the entirety of my life.
I am confident, I am strong, I am free from abuse, and I am happy in the place that I am with my family.
The happiest moment in my life, and I'm not sure if my sister's actually aware of this, was the birth of my niece. To know that the future generations of my family won't have to go through what I went through.
The world now looks like a big, beautiful, messy place. I think that looking around, you can see examples of that in every single person you meet. They have their own story to tell, they have their own struggles that they've gone through, and you know, the messiness and the tears and the pain and all of that, they lead us to appreciate the happy days and the good days and the lives that we, you know, will lead in a positive way. Like a